Hello, it's James Johnson, aka Sulphurblade. Welcome back to my channel, and welcome back to War on the Sea, where I am playing as the Japanese in the Rising Sun campaign, which is basically the reverse of the Pacific campaign. Anyway, in episode 1, we got things underway. We bought our initial fleets and got them sent out. And the first squabble, if you will, was carrier on carrier action near Wake Island. Except my escort of zeros turned around early because it was getting near nighttime, and I attempted to go to tactical to start a tactical battle because I had a feeling the enemy was in the neighborhood. When I pressed the tactical button, my 36 Kates showed up dangerously close to 24 Wildcats, which we didn't find the fleet, but we certainly found its Harrowing. And its Harrowing made quick work of one of our Kate wings. So we're down to 2/3 power in our carrier group. Anyway, with that being said, let's just jump in and get things started. Did I see something? Yeah, I'm seeing something here. It's probably planes coming from the Philippines. Would make sense. Actually, are you... You have arrived. Alright, what I want to do with this guy is set up a patrol. Continuous patrol, basically, where he's gonna do that in perpetuity. Just gonna constantly sail around Guam until he runs into something. In fact, with Samurai, we might do something pretty similar. We're going to go about here, 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 and set that up as a repeating box. That's going to be our carrier task force patrol box. For now on, for this moment in time anyway, we're concentrating on controlling our atolls here around the Caroline Islands. It's nighttime. Oh! We have arrived at Pella, though. Amphib Group 1, go ahead and manage cargo. Your supplies, your troops, supplies, Chitose, get supplies, Earl Morrow, his troops, and the rest of these is probably supplies. Spotting planes. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. Pause the phone. Anyo, launch me. Six zeros or so. Course. Course this way. gut is telling me. Yep. Heavy cruiser group. Go ahead and ignore for now. Oh, you're not who I thought you were. No. Why does it only look like one set of kates? I launched zeros. That's why it looks like one set of kates. Because it's not kates. Keep your eye on the prize, please. What is the weather? Oh my god. Sea State 7? That's gonna be hard to find them in. Might as well bring these 12 over here. There they are. Right, too tactical. Group. Something like that. The other cake group, you're entirely too close. Warm up. Head out this way. Zeros. Warm up, get fast. Really? Zeros can only do 288 knots? I guess that's right. And get moderately high. And fly right overhead. Drag flag. What's down there anyway? Four and five are the big dogs. Okay. All right, come on down to $390. Maz, I want to select the whole group. Good, unpause. We're gonna manually fly a little bit here. Alright, this group make your descent to 390, please. Target 5. Pause. Attack. You guys. Target 4. Attack. Zeros. Tight turn overhead. Lost to 0. Got a whole group of Kates coming in on this cruiser. Another 0 down. Kate, fish are away. That's a dead heavy cruiser. All right, where are my zeros? All you guys, target one, attack. Go strafe that transport. Down goes number five. True first blood has happened. The first capital ship has been sunk. Down. Fish are away. Okay, zeros are coming in to strafe. Only one torpedo? Seems like it. Well, that was too bad. Alright, zeros. What else do we have out here? Three is a merchant. Three and two are merchants. Should have been all of the zeros. Zeros lost. A Oh, we took it out. So one heavy cruiser, one transport. I'm thinking we're going to be content with the one heavy cruiser and one transport. We're going to wrap this battle up here. Our air group's getting a little banged up. We probably need to head back and rearm. Okay, so 5 command points gained. We've sunk 2 ships, a 10,000 ton merchant, a 9,000 ton. I'm pretty sure that was a heavy cruiser. I'm pretty much positive that's a heavy cruiser. In fact, which heavy cruiser was that? Ships, CAs, Pensacola does look right. Actually, North. I think it had 4 turrets though, didn't it? I think we... no, it wasn't in Baltimore. It was 9,050 tons though, right? Which is a Pensacola. I think we just sunk a Pensacola. Yeah, we did. We sunk the Pensacola. Excellent. You guys can RTB. These are Mavis's, right? Yep. So we need a certain amount of time to go by to be able to re-engage that fleet. And are they continuing to press on towards us, or did they turn around? Educated guess. If they turned around, puts them in that ballpark, maybe. We're going to try going to tactical. Oh, what's with this nice weather? Mavis is a spud and nothing. That seemed like good visibility where they're at. Are we on the edge of a... Yeah, we're on the edge of some sort of weather boundary. Alright, well, you guys go that way. And this other group, go that way. We still have spotters flying around. spotter. Jump into tactical. I see ships. These guys have not been deterred. They are pressing on. Both groups, rapid descension. 1, attack. These other Mavises. Target 1, an attack. Drop the torps, drops the torps! Torps away! Come on, big hits! Oh yeah! I want you guys to target that guy instead. torps away. Get fast. Climb high. British transport should be toast. That looks like a Northampton, huh? I mean, you took like four torps, and those are big torps. And you're supposedly laden with cargo. Or I would assume you're laden with cargo. You should be a dead ship. Planes are leaving the engagement area. Yeah! Come on, put them under! Yeah, they came alongside to pick up the survivors. Kind of the captain to come and rescue his, the Brits that didn't want to be swimming. That's what's happened, and I'm sticking to it. Okay. Let's go ahead and retreat out of this. So that's another heavy cruiser and another transport. Turn the weather off. I've just thought about something. Did I ever drop off? Didn't I load you guys with stuff? Manage cargo? Yeah, there is cargo on board. So, of course. Upon pay, we have cargo to drop off. Speaking of which, RTB Mavis's. Oh, and that's the last known position of that fleet, which is now a light cruiser fleet, I believe. Time. Do we have time? I feel like I'm missing a submarine. Should be one coming down towards Tarawa. There. Is that him? Yeah, that's him. Just gonna give her a try. If they turned around, they might be in this area. That's if they're visible yet, because again, I'm not sure how long it takes before you can reattack them. This weather and nighttime, it's gonna be hard to see anything. They had any brains, they would call off their attack. Unload all cargo. Now, we do have a heavy cruiser. Technically, we would outgun them if we got into a surface engagement. Am I going to be that reckless with aircraft carriers? I might. Honestly, I just might. So I have a rule to avoid surface engagements with them when all possible. But it's also really early in the campaign, and I'm gonna need all the all the quick victories I can get for points. Besides, we need to go back to rearm our aircraft anyway. We might as well go back to rearm some shells. So, they've got a transport with them, which means they're going to be going a little on the slow side. But if they're continuing forward, right about here might be the time to go to tactical. In this weather, at night, what are the chances we can find anything? I don't believe any of my ships have surface search radar. The Takao has air search radar, but not surface. Alright, it was worth a try. Not sure if I'm going to send you to Tarawa. I might just send you right in this area. Okay, air operations are now available. Spotter plane. Interesting location. Oh, okay. Usually Japanese subs carry float planes. Not this class, evidently. Alright. I think that's the box I want you to patrol. Float plane flying off this way. Emily with big HE bombs. Go fly in this area, Pompeii. Emily with big HEs. Fly off in that area too. Speaking of radar, me planes. You're not really going to tell me here if any of my planes have radar, right? I don't think Japanese planes do, actually. Weather is still terrible. Just waiting to see a hint of possibly a float plane to give us an idea where they may have gone. Stop. Kind of appeared right here. Either he's flying back to the fleet. Oh, the other one. Let's go to tactical. Saw a float plane heading back down here again. Don't get too far away from that float plane. Stay right near him. right here. It's the sudden vanishing leads me to think we are on top of it to tactical. Yep. Emily's, what are you sporting? Bombs, right? Yeah. Navigate this way, guys. And you guys need to come on down. You're the next contestants. Guys. Target one and attack. You guys. Target three and attack. Torps away, I think one set might hit. Come on! Oh! Lock. Well, that was disappointing. So a couple of bombs landed on that transport. I wanted to sink this guy. It would have been nice. Fire going out. Nope. Come on. Thank you. That's another 2 command points. And the last transport of this group sunk. give you a course. Something like that. That's your box. So even though I've played this game tons and tons, I still kind of forget. Do we get paid every 7 days or every month? How does that work again? So far, we have sunk Pensacola heavy cruiser, a Cameron merchant, a Northampton heavy cruiser, a transport merchant, and a small merchant. Small transport merchant. Works for me. Right. I don't remember if it's. Every 7 days or every month? I've been playing a lot of 7 Days to Die lately, so 7 days rings in my mind for something. But it kind of rings in my mind for this too, for some reason. Air operations now available. Pause. I saw something here. I know I did. Nine command points weekly, so it is weekly. Alright, and that'll also show us what did we get delivered. Engineering and fuel. So with our 81 points, we're going to put together a merchant fleet to start getting the engineering and fuel down to where? Is Truk going to be our... Yeah. Truk will be our huckleberry, if you will. Sanusi. Merchant. We'll start with an oiler. Are we going with cheap and slow? You cost 15, you cost 13. I mean, 150 fuel. What did we receive? 255. I think one oiler is good for now. So one Nippon Maru. Then back to merchants. It's 121 engineering at 15 knots. Less engineering, more speed. Way less engineering. So I guess this is our question. Do we want to spend You're certainly most engineering efficient. Are you, though? Yeah, I think we're gonna go with this guy. So that's 121 engineering and 150 fuel. Did I just do what I think I did? I did. We're getting how much engineering? I think we can go with two of these. So one oiler and two of these. And we need an escort for you. Are we going to give you a Chitose? Oh, we can afford it. It would give me peace of mind. And it can even carry some engineering. Okay. And then kamikazes. Two kamikazes. Yeah, we can afford it. And then that's what we'll do. Logistics group. How about 7? Done. Let's arrange you somehow. How are we going to arrange you? Battle line, no. To go. Battle line. 5 and 6, my destroyers. That's where they are. Yeah, perfect. Now then, let's manage cargo. You are here for engineering. Engineering, fuel, and fuel. With, I don't know, how about some supplies and a handful of troops. Take the shortest possible route to Truk. Yes. Good. Then we have one more thing we need to do. should be it. And I need to check if my planes are getting hung up or if they're continuing their... Looks like they're continuing their things without a problem, isn't it? I don't see any sitting around. That's good. Though the hung-ups usually would happen on reload of game. Jake has found what? An encounter? Wait, a Jake has. Caroline Islands. Really? New air. Betty's. Course. Right there, please. And where are you? What do we got here? Roofies to fly cover. I mean, do I want them to stray from me? I probably... Stay above M for group one. Ignore it. Let's mark this. Another mark. HE. Something's going on by Formosa. Look at that. Look at that. Okay. The tactical. Pause. What are you guys? Are you guys dive bombers or are you... Don't know what kind of bombers those Judies are. They're flat bombers, dive bombers, or what? Betty's, however, are torpedo bombers. They can start descending to... And let's tighten up the formation a little bit. Stay in a Vic. We got down here. There is indeed a carrier. This is a proper fleet. Judy's. Target the aircraft carrier. Good luck. Betty's. You're not on the deck yet, are you? Start turning towards the target, though. Uh-oh. Cap in the air. Everybody, attack one, please. Thank you. How are our Judy's doing here? They're having a bad time of it. And the Betty's? The Betty's gonna make it? Probably not. Can this Betty make it? Nope. It was a valiant effort. Wasp? Are you Wasp? Which one are you? Are you a Yorktown? So the crane, that thingy sticking up there. You look like a Yorktown, don't you? Yeah, you're definitely not a Lexington. Not an Essex. You're one of the Yorktowns. Any hull number on her? Is that the big E? The way its flyers shut down our planes, you might be the big E. No. Okay, retreat. Leave. Confirm. Okay, well, somewhere over here. I think Truk's out of planes, right? I think the biggie gets away to hurt us another day. We just got to make sure that the biggie doesn't launch a full strike on our amphib group here. Kind of doing a parallel course to us. That's not exactly optimal. Yeah, she has her sights glued on us, doesn't she? Oh, what's going on by Formosa? These guys are heavy fighters. Alright, Kates, go explore what's happening over here. Nothing so far. Boy, there's a lot of spotting aircraft here. There's gotta be something in the area, the general vicinity. This isn't good. Change your course. It's about that time of night. Jump into tactical. See if we can get lucky. Look at that. Oh. Big guns. There's no way we can sink that with three Kates. Is there? I mean, we'd be really lucky. Although this British ship looks like a nice juicy target. And there's a nice juicy target. You know, let's do some damage to the Brits. With the Kates, let's keep her nice and tight. Target two and attack. If we can get all three torps on target, we got a good shot of sinking her. Gonna be flying into a lot of flak. I do feel good about our angle of attack here. They haven't opened up fire on us yet. Darkness might be giving us some cover. Here they go. Torps away. Warm up. Oh, don't form up with that one. You and you. Warm up. Thank you. Speed up. Climb. Navigate that way. She's gonna take one. So we kissed her on the nose. She'll probably survive it. Although, we might possibly get some lucky hits in. Maybe. Three is the one that I think we have a chance of hitting here. Having a hard time seeing the torps. Is that them there? Yeah? Oh, did the torps just run out of gas? They did. Well, that's too bad. How did your kiss on the cheek go, buddy? Like I'll live. Yeah, he's fine. Moderate, moderate. That is concerning. It's a battleship and heavy cruisers that could come in and bombard our facilities on Formosa. All right. Amphib group 1. Let's get back to heading to target. Yeah, they gotta be planning to bombard. It's always the early days of the campaign when the computer has the most opportunity to do damage. I have a feeling Formosa is going to get bombarded. Or it should. Might be heading to Okinawa. But the way they put the spotters up here. Whoa! Hello. What's going on with Truk here? Well, that's awfully close. Truk, you have any air left? Not really? Pelalu? Betty's? Something like that. Well, anyway, this is probably a good time to wrap up this episode. So this has been episode 2 of the Rising Sun campaign. I'm James Johnson, a.k.a. Sulfurplate. This is my content. Hopefully you're enjoying it. If so, consider smashing that like button and consider subscribing. Also, before we log off here, let's just check out the enemy's losses to date. 5 ships, total of 38,000 tons, including 2 heavy cruisers and 3 merchants. We've slightly wounded another heavy cruiser. We saw a battleship fleet out here around Formosa, and we saw either the Hornet, the Enterprise, or the Yorktown sailing down here south of Truk. We also had contact that came here near Truk, which, according to Truk's intelligence, was not that carrier fleet. So the Allies are most indeed out in full force, and we're kind of hurting. We don't exactly have very big airfields on these islands, and our primary big hitter is heading back to rearm. Otherwise, it's really slow submarines that can't exactly quickly react to help out. So we just kind of got to hope that the submarines are at the right spot at the right time so that they can inflict some damage. But so far, the subs haven't been lucky. But, you know, it's early in campaign. We're going to get there. It's a little tough right now, but things will get better. Anyway, I'm James Johnson, a.k.a. Sulfurblade. This is my content. Hopefully you're enjoying it. If so, please smash that like button. Consider subscribing. And until the next time, all, peace.